All right, so like I said in the last Disney video, I have only 10 movies left to review, including this one. We're almost done. We are at the home stretch of this long series of reviews, but I'm also at the era of Disney animation that I have been dreading the most. More than the wartime era, more than the bronze or transitional era, this particular era of the post-Renaissance contains several movies that I have not really been looking forward to watching. But let's just get this thing started. Hey everyone, it's Alexander, the real Mr. Robinson. Welcome to the channel. This is my review for Treasure Planet, which is the 43rd Disney animated movie overall. Released in 2002, the same year as Lilo and Stitch, and is directed by Ron Clements and John Musker. The movie is a modified adaptation of Robert Louis Stevenson's Treasure Island, except this time it takes place in a different galaxy, with alien races, in outer space, and instead of an island, it's a planet that holds buried treasure. The movie opens up with a young Jim Hawkins being told the story of Treasure Planet by his mother, and he's so entranced with the story that he actually believes it to be real. Cut to many years in the future, where he's now a little bit older and voiced by Joseph Gordon-Levitt, which is something I didn't know until I saw this movie. He has grown up to be a juvenile delinquent and a troublemaker because his father left him and his mother at a very young age. But while he's helping his mother take care of this inn, a pirate shows up in front of the door with a treasure map to Treasure Planet. And along with a scientist voiced by David Hyde Pierce, they set off on an expedition to try to find Treasure Planet. It's an iconic story that has been done many, many times before. In fact, this particular story was told by Disney themselves just a few years before this movie came out, but they did it with Muppets. And if I'm going to be completely honest, I think they did a better job with Muppets than they did with science fiction. Back when I reviewed Lilo and Stitch, I mentioned that that was the last Disney movie I saw in a theater. Everything else from this point on up until Princess and the Frog, I kind of avoided. Not deliberately, and if you've been following my channel for a long time, you know I've talked about my anti-animation phase. No, that phase hasn't happened yet. The reason I didn't see Treasure Planet in a theater is because out of the two Disney animated movies that came out in 2002, Lilo and Stitch seemed like the more interesting one, whereas Treasure Planet just, I didn't quite know what to make of it. Since then, it's developed a cult following, much like with Atlantis, but I just never really had the energy to watch the movie itself until just now when I decided to review all these Disney movies weekly. And this movie is pretty much everything that I thought Atlantis was going to be. And I don't mean that in a positive light. Going back to my review for Atlantis: The Lost Empire, one of the things that I really admired about that movie is how it was an adventure film, a very straightforward one, but it was disguised as a Disney movie. It didn't have a lot of Disney-esque tropes to it. It felt more in the vein of Indiana Jones, which I definitely appreciated. Treasure Planet, unfortunately, feels very Disney-fied, and more specifically, Michael Eisner-era Disney-fied, because it's just overall uninspired, it's cliched, the characters are just kind of one note. If they're not one note, then they're just obnoxious. But there are some cool ideas behind this. The concept to take this classic adventure story like Treasure Island and set it in a science fiction world with advanced technology and spaceships, even though they do look like traditional pirate ships, is neat. It doesn't quite have that cool steampunk feeling that Atlantis: The Lost Empire had, but you can definitely tell there was some inspiration when it came to the design of this movie. And some of the alien creatures are actually pretty cool. Mainly when they look more like aliens, when they actually look like anthropomorphic animals, like David Hyde Pierce's dog scientist and Emma Thompson's cat captain, that's when it gets a little weird. Similar to with Lilo and Stitch, except this time around, it's the entire movie. But you know what? It's science fiction. I can let it all pass as long as it's interesting. Which unfortunately is not the case, because I found this movie to be incredibly boring. And it's all due to the characters. Jim Hawkins is your very typical and by the numbers juvenile delinquent. He doesn't have any of the charm or personality that Aladdin does. David Hyde Pierce is pretty much playing Niles Crane from Frasier, except he's an anthropomorphic dog. And as for Emma Thompson's character, she has a few cool moments here and there, but she didn't leave that much of an impression at the end of the day. The only character that actually had some sort of personality was Brian Murphy as John Silver, the mutinous villain of the movie who actually has a very soft spot for Jim Hawkins. And instead of simply a peg leg, he's half a cyborg. And when this guy first comes on the screen, you instantly think, bad guy, huh? But as this movie progressed, I'd forgotten that John Silver as a character has a soft spot for Jim Hawkins, and he becomes the father figure that Jim never really had since his old dad was a deadbeat. And by the end of the movie, he's the only character that has something of a full-fledged arc, where he just puts his greed aside and tries to get away and start a new life. And that's the only character that's really worth a damn in this movie. As for your comic relief, you have Morph, which is this tiny shape-shifting alien. And when it comes to Disney sidekicks, Morph is one of the worst in my opinion, because not only is he just obnoxious, but he's also a troublemaker. He actively causes problems for the main characters, and I'm like, seriously? Nobody would have tolerated this little glop of goop after a while. But somehow the characters keep doing it. And then as for Martin Short's robot character, Ben, he comes in very late in the movie and is mainly there to shout his lines. I feel like more than any other Disney sidekick that they were really trying to make the next genie. And considering that this is not only Ron Clements and John Musker, but they also co-wrote the story with Ted Elliott and Terry Rossio. So it makes sense that they'd want to try to replicate the same thing that they did with Aladdin, but it really does not work this time. I really have nothing else to say about this movie. I recognize that it's gained a cult following, but you have to understand, I'm reviewing this from the perspective of somebody who did not see this in theaters when it came out. I literally saw it just a few days ago, and as somebody who watched it for the first time as a 30-year-old man, it really did not impress me. So I'm gonna say don't waste your money on it. Like I said, Muppet Treasure Island is a better interpretation of Robert Louis Stevenson's book. And this is just so generic and so uninspired outside of some of the production design that it's hard to get on board with it. And also, probably the most egregious scene in the movie is when Jim Hawkins is having a flashback to when his dad leaves him, and there's this obnoxious pop song that plays in the background. And it's so on the nose and so melodramatic in a way that for a second I thought Zack Snyder had taken over the movie. I'm like, wait, what's going on here? This feels so out of place and so shoehorned into the movie that I got Doc Major points for that. It's not a movie that made me angry, but this is certainly a movie that I will never be revisiting again. And there you go, that's my review for Treasure Planet. Now next week we're going to be talking about another Disney animated movie that I have not seen, and as of this recording, still haven't seen. Brother Bear. Even when I saw the trailers as a kid for this movie, it was one where I went, I do not want to see this, but I've got no choice. So next week you'll see my review for Brother Bear. But right now I want to know what you guys think about Treasure Planet. If you've seen it, what did you think? Whatever the case may be, let me know in the comments below. And until next time, this is the real Mr. Robinson telling you there's only one. Hello everyone, I just wanted to say thank you all for watching my review for Treasure Planet. Make sure you like the video, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell button to get notifications. Don't forget to follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, go check out my Twitch channel, and support me on Patreon. I'll see you guys in the next video, but until then, have a good day and take care of yourselves.